Hello student, welcome to the KTHM e-learning portal. I am Pratik Shinde, dealing with the subject Environmental Biology and the Toxicology. Today we are going to cover the topic Forest and Pond Ecosystem. We will study in this lecture major ecosystem in detail. There are different kind of ecosystem that we see in a previous lecture, but we just revise them. Those are natural ecosystem and artificial ecosystem. In the natural ecosystem are again classified into two categories, the terrestrial ecosystem and aquatic ecosystem. In the terrestrial ecosystem, we will study the forest ecosystem, and in the aquatic ecosystem, we will study the pond ecosystem, that is the type of freshwater ecosystem. In the artificial ecosystem, we will study the cropland ecosystem. Forest ecosystem. A forest ecosystem is a functional unit or a system which comprises of soil, tree, insect, animal, bird, and man as its interacting unit. A forest is a large and complex ecosystem and hence has greater species diversity. Also, it is much more stable and resistant to the unfavorable changes as compared to the small ecosystem, such as wetland and grassland ecosystem. A forest ecosystem, similar to any other ecosystem, also contain of abiotic and abiotic components. According to their distance from the equator, we can broadly divide the type of forest into the following types. First is tropical forest, second is temperate forest, and third is boreal and taiga forest. The tropical forest, a type of forest found in the area with high regular rainfall and no low temperature and low rainfall, and the containing of completely closed covering of tree that prevent the entry of sunlight to the ground. Second is temperate forest. The temperate forest are the region where the climate change a lot from summer to winter. The temperate forest are almost always made up of two type of trees, the deciduous tree and evergreen trees. The deciduous trees are trees that lose their leaves in the winter, and evergreen trees that keep them all the year. The boreal or taiga forest, also known as snow forest. The boreal forest ecosystem is the connecting green belt of conifer and deciduous trees that encircle a large portion of northern hemisphere. The forest ecosystem is the example of the terrestrial ecosystem. Roughly 40% of the total land occupied by forest. In India, roughly 1/10 of the total land occupied by forest. Abiotic component of the forest contains soil, water, and rock. The climatic factors such as temperature, sunlight, and rainfall. Sunlight is necessary to plant for photosynthesis. Abiotic component interact with biotic component. The biotic component are the living factors. Biotic component include producer, consumer, and decomposer. We start with producer. The producers are the autotrophs. In a forest, the producer are mainly plants. Plants trap solar energy in the presence of water and carbon dioxide, produce food by the process of photosynthesis. Tectona grandis and Soria robusta, these are the dominant plant species found in a tropical deciduous forest. Pinus and rhododendron, These are the dominant plant species found in the temperate conifer and the temperate deciduous forest. Then the consumer. Consumer is divided into different tropical level, such as primary consumer, secondary consumer, and the top consumer or the tertiary consumer. First, we see the primary consumer. These are the herbivores which feed directly on producers. For example, ant, beetles, bugs, spider, etc. They feeding on tree leaves. The large animals such as elephant, deer, squirrel, giraffe, grazing on shoot and fruit of the tree. Then the secondary consumer. These are the carnivores and feed on primary consumers. The carnivores means they feed on other living organism or simply called as meat eater. For example, bird, lizard, frog, snake and foxes. The tertiary consumer. These are the top carnivores. For example, lion and tiger. They feed on carnivores of secondary consumer level. Then the decomposer. Decomposition is an extremely oxygen required process. In the process of decomposition, decomposers convert the complex organic compound of debris into inorganic substance such as carbon dioxide, water and nutrient. The debris in the remain of the dead plant such as leaves, bark, flower and also the dead remain of animal include their fecal matter. The steps involved in the process of decomposition are fragmentation, catabolism and humification. The process of decomposition requires some microorganisms such as fungi and bacteria. The example of fungi, Aspergillus, Polyporus, Fusarium, Trichoderma, etc. And the example of bacteria, Bacillus, Pseudomonas, Actinomycete, Streptomycin. Then the pond ecosystem. A pond as a whole serves a good example of freshwater ecosystem. A pond is self-sufficient and self-regulating system. It is consist both living as well as non-living component. If you examine a bottle of pond water or mud, we shall show the living organism, plant as well as animal, and the mixture of inorganic and organic compound. That's why the whole system become much complex. The different component of pond ecosystem are as follow. Abiotic component. Abiotic component of pond ecosystem are formed as result of mixture of some organic and inorganic material. They have directly or indirectly effect on aquatic organism of the pond. They include light, temperature, heat, diesel oxygen, carbon dioxide, other gases, pH of water, the turbidity, dissolved minerals, amino acid and humic acid. The rate of release of this abiotic substance depend upon the solar input, cycle of temperature and the climatic condition. Then the biotic component. Biotic component are the living factors. Biotic component include producer, consumer and decomposer. We start with producer. Producer are autotrophic green plant and some photosynthetic bacteria. The producer fix solar energy in the presence of water and carbon dioxide. They produce food as a carbohydrate by the process of photosynthesis. Producers are of the two types, macrophytes and phytoplanktons. Macrophytes, these are the rooted, submerged large plant found in marginal area of pond. In the pond, found some common plant species. Those are Trapa, Typha, Nymphaea, Chara, Hydrilla, Utricularia. Beside them, some free-floating plants such as Azolla, Salvinia, Ulfia, Spirodella, and Lemna. Phytoplanktons, these are the non-rooted floating minute lower plant or algae. The example of phytoplanktons such as Spirogyra, Cladophora, Closterium, Cosmarium, Eudorina, Pandorina, Volvax, Diatoms, and Anavena. Then the consumer. These are the heterotrophic. They depend for food on producers. The primary consumer are herbivore. Primary consumer, also known as macro consumer, are herbivore feeding directly on living plant or plant remains. They may be large as well as minute in size. The herbivores are further differentiated as benthic population, mammals, bird, and zooplankton. But we focus on benthic population and zooplanktons. The benthic population includes fish, insect larvae, beetle, mites, mollusks, crustacean. Some mammals as cow, buffalo, etc. also visit the pond casually and feed on marginal rooted macrophytes. Some birds also regularly visit the pond feeding on some hydrophytes. Zooplanktons, these are the mostly rotifer as branchios, some protozoans as euglena and crustacean like cyclops are also. Then the secondary consumer. Secondary consumer are the carnivores which feeds on primary consumer are herbivores. They are mostly insect and fishes. Most insect as water beetles feeds on zooplankton. The other example of secondary consumer such as crab, mayfly larva, and dragonfly larva. Then the tertiary consumer. The tertiary consumers are also carnivores and include some large fishes as game fish that feeds on the smaller fish and thus become a top consumer. The other example of the tertiary consumers are Cutla Cutla and Notopterus. Then the decomposer. In the process of decomposition, the microorganisms play an important role. They convert the complex organic compound of debris into the inorganic substance such as carbon dioxide, water, and nutrient. In the process of decomposition, required some microorganisms such as fungi and bacteria. The example of fungi, Aspergillus, Cladosporium, Rhizopus, Penicillium, and the Trichoderma. The example of bacteria, Actinomycete and Streptomycin. In pond ecosystem, we have to study a biotic component and abiotic component. Here we see a biotic component. A biotic component such as sun, soil, water, and the atmospheric gases. These are the included under the abiotic component of the pond ecosystem. Then the biotic component. Biotic component includes producers, consumer, and decomposers. In the producer, we see the macrophytes, means rooted, submerged, large plant. They found the marginal area of the pond. Then we see the phytoplanktons. The phytoplanktons, filamentous algae, found on the top of the water of the pond. Then the primary consumer. The primary consumers include protozoans, crustaceans and the rotifers. They feed on these macrophytes and phytoplanktons. Then the secondary consumers. Secondary consumers such as small fishes, they feed on these zooplanktons and some insect larva. For example, dragonfly larva, they feed on these zooplanktons. Then the top consumer. The top consumer are the carnivores, they feed on the secondary consumer. Here this large fish feeds on these small fish. Then last is decomposer. The decomposer includes some fungi and bacteria. They decompose the plant and animal dead material and again they recycle into the ecosystem. In this lecture, we have to study the forest ecosystem and the pond water ecosystem and its abiotic and biotic components. Thank you.